Greetings and welcome to Lutheran State of Kansas Christ. My name is Pastor Jeffrey A. Johnson, Sr. I'm the senior pastor of the Eastern Star Church in Indianapolis, Indiana, with my church in three locations. I've been with this ministry for 21 years. The church is almost 90 years old. I've been preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ for 30 years. Because I've planted several churches and mentored plenty of young pastors, one of the things I try to get close to each of them is the importance of the Word of God. I believe it's so often we get caught up in so many other things in ministry. Of course, we have so many things to do as pastors of these churches and as leaders of Christian movements, but we have to get back to the Word of God. We cannot forget the importance of God's Word, because it has been inspired by God's Holy Spirit. And of course, the Word is the authority for the life of the believer and the life of the church. So we have to get back to that. I know that we have to do consultation. I know that we have to do visitation. I know we have to do administration. We have so many things that are extremely important to the ministry, development of others in our life. But we cannot forget God's Word. It's a lifelong thing. It's a lifelong thing. It's so important for us to have some integrity when it comes to what God has already spoken to us, so that we ourselves can have personal development. We need to stay in God's Word because we need to continue to grow. We need to understand God's Word for our lives. We need to know the direction that God would have for us to move. And it helps us in terms of our personal devotion. The Bible teaches us that we've got to have the Word of our life, that we might not sin against God. How can a young person cleanse their ways by taking heed to the Word of God when everything else passes away? God's Word is still going to be here. And understand this. When we put the emphasis on the Word of God as we should, but when it comes to what we're trying to do in ministry, now the arguments go out the window. People can argue with my opinion, but they cannot argue with those persons, whether it's my congregation or our leadership or the ministry of those who are trying to work with us. They cannot argue with God's Word. So when God lays in my heart, what the plan for this ministry and what we're going to do, I preach it. I'm teaching right out of God's Word, and I just stay with it in God's Word until everybody understands that this is what God wants us to do. Far too often we expect to have consequences from people who have no character. We expect character from people who we have not given any content to. So we've got to give people the content of God's inspired Word, His living Word, and then that content of the Word will build their Christian character, and the consequences will take care of themselves. I encourage you, get in the Word of God. It gives you the power. It gives your church what it means. It gives your ministry what it means. And I'm going to tell you, God is not going to disappoint when it comes to His Word. My son has an iPhone, and he was telling me how he was trying to plug his iPhone into his MacBook computer in order to get a charge up. So he said he took his iPhone, plugged it into his MacBook. But the phone did not charge. I guess he was frustrated, getting upset. I said, "My son, what happened? Did you get it?" He said, "No, I didn't get it. I finally understood it. When the phone was getting no juice, when it was generating no power, it's because the book was closed." He said, "But when I opened the book, that's when the phone started getting the power." That's how so many of us are. We get plugged into the church and plugged into ministry and plugged into vision and plugged in to what God would have for us to do. We're plugged into the people in our lives, but we have no real power, no real supernatural body power until we open God's Word. And when you open that Word, I guarantee you, I'm a living witness, that God will give you the power that is necessary to accomplish His will on this earth, so that you might advance the kingdom of God's Word. That's my peace to you. That's what I'm trying to advise you to get. Get in God's Word. Stay in that Word. Help the people of God to understand that the Word of God is the authority for the life of the believer, the life of the church. And I guarantee you, God will give you the authority